हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। आई होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड साउंड एट होम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ फाइनल टर्म, दैट इज चैप्टर 9, सिंपल एंड कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट। लेट अस सी व्हाट इज सिंपल इंटरेस्ट। सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इज द इंटरेस्ट चार्ज ऑन द लोन। नाउ इन अदर वर्ड्स वी कैन से दैट If we have taken a loan of 1000 from a bank at 10% per annum for 1 year, so the simple interest will be, how to calculate the simple interest? So SI is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. Now what the principal is 1000, rate is 10%, time is 1 year upon 100. So the interest that we have to give along with the principal will be rupees 100. Now how to calculate amount? The amount that we have to give to the bank after 1 year will be amount is equal to principal plus interest. So the principal is ₹1000 and the interest is ₹10. So after 1 year, the amount that we have to give to the bank or return to the bank is ₹1010. Now the formula that we use to find out simple interest is, simple interest is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. Principal is the amount that we have taken from a bank, rate is 10% over year, and time is 1 year. So using this formula we can find out the simple interest as well as the amount. Now if we have to find out simple interest, how we are going to find out principal? Then simple interest into 100 upon rate into time is the formula that we are going to use. If we have to find out rate, then rate will be equal to simple interest into 100 upon principal into time. Again, if we have to calculate time, then it will be equal to simple interest into 100 upon principal into rate. Now after finding out simple interest, if we have to find out the amount that we have to return, so we are going to use a formula, amount is equal to principal plus interest. I hope all the formulas are very much clear to everyone. Now there are certain things that we have to keep it in mind while using a formula. Firstly, the time should be given in years, then easily you can calculate simple interest. If time is given in days, what we are going to do? We are going to divide it by 365. If time is given in months, we are going to divide it by 12. And if time is given in weeks, we divide it by 52. Second thing, if specific days of deposit and withdrawal are given, like 25th May to 2nd October, so what we are going to do? Then to calculate the time, generally the day of deposit is counted. So we are going to count the day of deposit on which day, but the day of withdrawal is not counted. On which day we are taking a loan or we are depositing the money, on that day will be calculated. But on which day the amount is being withdrawn or I am going to return the amount, that day is not going to be calculated. Let us see with the help of an example. Calculate the simple interest on ₹2500 for 3 years 6 months at 11% per annum. What is the amount payable? As we all know, SI is equal to principal into rate into time upon 100. So over here principal is given to you as 2500, into time is 3 years 6 months means 3.5. So when we are going to calculate, you are going to get 7/2 into 11, rate of interest is 11 multiplied by 100. So when you are going to calculate, you are going to get 1925/2, and approximately it is equal to 962.5. Now this is the interest. So the amount which is payable is amount is equal to principal plus interest. So it will be 2500 plus 962.5, that is 346250. I hope all the topics are clear to everyone. Next time when we are going to meet, I am going to start with the second part of the chapter. Till then, be safe and goodbye.